Summer Erin, and welcome to a little bit of a different video. It's visually not going to be super exciting, but I really wanted to do this. It's basically, if you saw the title, you know what this is. Basically, it is just me kind of talking very shortly about a couple small simmers that I would love you guys to check out. They did not ask me to do this. They do not know I am doing this. But I just really wanted to talk about some small simmers that I personally know and have really enjoyed both their attitudes and their content, and I think they all deserve more attention than they're getting. And basically, I just hope that you guys will be open to maybe checking their channels out. Like I said, this doesn't benefit me in any way, and I was not asked to do this. I'm sorry I don't have a face cam. I know, like, I could do it, but I'm kind of scared, so leave me in the comments below. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do face cam. But we are just going to go for real quickly through these channels, and you're going to have to listen to me, obviously, because it's not the most exciting video in the world. But I do hope you enjoy just kind of listening, and maybe you guys already know about these people. But if you don't, here's your introduction. So the first person we're going to start with, obviously, is Swee Sims. I believe they are from Sweden. I think that's why their name is Swee Sims. And I apologize if I'm mispronouncing anybody's name. Basically, Swee Sims started pretty recently. I'm going to try to figure out when they started. I don't know why it matters. Yeah, wow. So Swee Sims is actually newer than me. I started in this past December, like the end of December. So just a little bit newer than me. But yeah, so they basically have, right now going on, they have this Dream Life series. I'm obviously not going to play anything while we're doing this. So the Dream Life series is kind of like one of those things where it's like, you know, like, you guys know what that means. Like, you know, you kind of pretend like it's your life and etc. And it's kind of just like a nice family let's play, you know, nothing super juicy, but kind of just enjoyable and relaxing. So I do recommend that. The other thing I do like that they do is they do different, just little challenges here and there. So they have this mystery cash challenge right here. Just kind of fun, you know, who doesn't like a genetics challenge? I know a lot of people do that, but it was well done. The other thing I do want to say, though, that they do that's a little bit unique is they have this whole series right here. You'll see this Harry Potter series. So they have Harry Potter cast series. So if anyone likes Harry Potter, basically it's not the characters in Harry Potter, but it's like Harry Potter themed Sims. Does that make sense? So there's one for Gryffindor right here. You'll see this is Ravenclaw, Slytherin, and Hufflepuff. Actually, it was a collab with Genie Sims. Genie Sims is also another great simmer you should check out. I am not featuring them in this current video, but I do think I will do another video with other Sims. So definitely check out Genie Sims too. They are not included in this video currently. However, that's basically, like I said, Swee Sims is pretty new. So they don't have quite as much content as some other people because they literally started 3 weeks ago. But I really definitely check out the Dream Life series if you want just like a fun family let's play. It's, I believe, like 8 or 9 episodes in. Yeah. And like I said, definitely the Hogwarts stuff I can definitely recommend. So we're going to go ahead and close out that tab because I have all these tabs open. And we're going to go ahead to Retro Sims. So Retro Sims is a just really, just like Swee Sims, just a really, really sweet person. And just I've really been enjoying getting to know them. And they have really supported, I'm not going to lie, like a lot of these people have supported my channel from the beginning. So I'm a little bit biased, but I really enjoy their content. And Retro Sims is basically, their channel is basically focused on built. So if you guys like speed builds, especially family homes, suburban homes, a little bit smaller stuff, but like really down to earth stuff with really pleasant music, I definitely suggest you check out Retro Sims. Like, they put me in such a good mood every time. You guys know I'm an uber stressed out person. If you don't know, now you know. And they just put me in such a good mood. I'm trying to see if I can find like one particular I really liked of their home builds. Like, this is nice. I'm kind of a sucker for like libraries and cafes, but just really pleasant stuff. Just a lot of like, you see this one, like it's an apartment, just like a lot of like kind of like modern and also rustic vibes. I know that made no sense. But just like a couple different styles, but like a little bit more homey than a lot of stuff I see. Like, it's not super sleek and stuff, but like really homey. Like I've said many times, like I would love to live in one of your houses, basically. So definitely check that out if you want like kind of more down to earth builds and just some really, just like a really pleasant time. They're fairly short videos, you know, lower commitment and stuff. They are actually starting this right here. If you see this new Let's Play Sims 4. Yeah, so I think it's like kind of like a dream life kind of thing again. So like they created their Sim self. And I don't know what's going to happen in it yet. I only saw like the first part. So they actually just started recording voiceovers for the first time. So they're like, maybe I shouldn't say this, but they're really stressed out. A lot of people are stressed out about voiceovers. But definitely give them a chance because I personally think that there's some great potential there. And like I said, their builds are just, I love them. They just make me feel happy. So that's Retro Sims. By the way, all these will be linked down below, hopefully, if I do my job. And if I don't, just yell at me. Next up is Coda Cakes. Again, I do apologize if I'm not pronouncing the names right. Not that it's their real name, but it's, you know. So Coda Cakes is another person I have personally talked to quite a bit, and I think Coda Cakes is just an awesome, amazing person. All these people are, honestly. And I really do think that their material is great, too. The biggest thing that Coda Cakes is doing, I believe Coda Cakes, I always like to look because I'm just curious. No, Coda Cakes has been around for a while, but I don't know that they've been producing content for that long because I think that's just when you join YouTube account. Doesn't make sense. I feel like they're fairly new, too. But their main thing right now is the 100 Baby Challenge. I know a lot of you guys love that. In fact, a lot of you guys, beg me to do it, which I'm always like, ugh. So, like, in the meantime, while I'm not doing it, you can check out Coda Cakes. Coda Cakes 100 Baby Challenge. Coda, like me, has kind of, well, you guys don't notice it, but I feel like Coda has some kind of, like, sarcasm that's, like, really, to me, I really like. And just, like, really down to earth. And it's really fun just, like, dealing with, like, the potty training and all that stuff. So that's a good one. Coda Cakes also, I forgot to mention, does have this other series. It's a legacy challenge. That's correct. And you can tell I'm hovering over it because I'm not going to lie. I have not really checked that out, so I can't tell you for sure. Well, I have checked it out some. I've watched a couple videos, but I have not checked it out. I've even watched it from the beginning. So I've only watched, like, the most recent videos, if that makes sense. So I do like it, but I can't tell you a ton about it yet because I'm, like, still getting acquainted. But definitely if you want another, like, get famous Let's Play with kind of following more, like, a central character, definitely check it out. It's fun. I really do like it so far from what I've seen, but I'm going to have to go back and, you know, check that out. And then beyond that, like, that's pretty much what they mainly are focused on. They do have a couple Tawny makeovers, I'm assuming. Haven't really talked to them about this recently, but, like, I'm assuming they'll do more. I believe as far as Tawny makeovers go, we had, yeah, the Goths. So we had a Goth. I think we had another Goth. Yeah, Bella Goth. Really well done. Like, stays true to their style, but updates them. And that's what I really like. Sometimes people really overdo those. Which they always look good, but they don't look like the same person, you know what I mean? So I really like those. Also a great one of Penny Pizzazz. I don't personally know Penny Pizzazz. Well, I mean, no one does. What am I talking about? But, like, I don't own the game that Penny Pizzazz is in. Is that Get Famous? I don't even know. But anyway, Tawny Makeover, very well done too. So, Coda Cakes, highly recommend. Okay, next person, Lady Andrak. Andrak, oh my gosh, I'm sorry, Lady Andrak, if I'm mispronouncing your Sim name. So Lady Andrak, again, I keep saying this, guys, but, like, I seriously love all these people. They're so kind, they're so nice, they will interact with all of their subs, and I just really love them. Lady Andrak is actually quite funny without being, like, over the top, like I'm trying too hard. Like, I just think she's hilarious. I love all of her videos, I really look forward to them. And, yeah, so basically Lady Andrak, their stuff is, first of all, there's this fun playlist, guys. If you like really crazy, wacky stuff, which you might be if you watch my channel, check out the Def House series. It's a 4-episode commitment, and basically it's just crazy. It involves vampires, it obviously involves Def. I'm not going to say anything else, but there's some really weird stuff going on. It's really fun. Lots of fun. I could tell they had a lot of fun making that too. So definitely suggest that one. The other thing I'm going to definitely suggest is if you want another 100 Baby Challenge, this one is further along than Coda Cakes was. It's 34 episodes in. So like that one too. I've only seen the more recent episodes, but like I was able to jump right in. I love it as well. It's different. It's a little bit, I don't know how to explain how it's different than Coda Cakes, but I really like both of them for different reasons. And recently they just moved into a new house. Both of them really get the nuance of like how crazy it is to do a 100 baby challenge. And like they just bring, I don't know, like Coda Cakes, I really love the kind of like undertone humor. And for Lady Andrac, I really love the energy, like just so much energy in this. Without being obnoxious, and I just really love it. Lady Andrac also has a Get Famous Let's Play. I'm not gonna lie, I have only sort of seen some, so that one I don't know as much about. I'm like really into the 100 Baby Challenge, which I don't even like 100 Baby Challenges, and I like Coda Cakes and Lady Andrac. I'm serious, I don't even like that challenge, and I like those, so I'm really into those. Lady Andrac is also super talented with speed builds. Let me see if I can pull one up for you. Well, I'm not gonna literally pull one up for you, because I don't want it to play. But yeah, so just like basically this was a really cool one, this Victorian Gothic home. Like if you're into anything like that, like, well, that sounded weird, but like it's just really good, really well done. I'm trying to remember what else they did. I know I'm super unprepared. They do other stuff like, okay, this was a review a year ago, so I don't know anything about that because I haven't seen it. But anyway, I think they've done some other speed builds, just like a couple, like a retail boutique. All of them, like there's only a couple, like I said, but they are definitely worth checking out. Like the Tiny Cabin in the Woods. Yes, I like that one. So like, I like all their speed builds, but like they're more of a Let's Play channel. Does that make sense? But definitely have talent in building. So I'm assuming we're going to see some more builds in the future. So that's Lady Andrac. Andrac. I can't talk. Sorry. Okay, Ryala. Okay, Ryala. Ryala is quite possibly, like, I talk to Ryala all the time on Twitter. I really wish I could meet them in person. Just, like, complete sweetheart. Really, really like Ryala. We have obviously, like, well, not obviously to you guys, but we've gone back and forth a lot talking to each other, talking about, like, how we can grow our channels and what we want to do for content. And it just really has made me feel really welcome, and I just really like Ryala, so I'm gonna stop saying that. But they do have some really good content, mostly builds and cash challenges, and actually there's a big update for Ryala's channel. Also, Ryala is very new. Why do I keep checking this? It doesn't really matter. Yeah, so Ryala joined only like 10 days or something like that before me, so we're kind of like in the same boat. So Ryala is actually going to start, I believe, doing voiceover some. Has not yet, but I am really excited for that, and I think it's gonna be great. They're actually gonna do a Q, and I think they're gonna do a Q&A. I'm getting so confused because I talk to different people. I'm pretty sure they're gonna do a Q&A. I'm sorry, Ryala, if I'm wrong. And, it's gonna be really fun, and then perhaps we're going to do a Let's Play in the future. But the reason I really like Ryala, besides personally, is their speed builds are just, I love them, okay? I really love them, and they do, like, again, like, kind of simple. Maybe that's just what I like, but, like, realistic stuff. My favorite one to date, though, by far, is this one. See this one right here? The Small Abandoned Home. Oh, my gosh. It doesn't, you might be like, what? But, like, give it a try. It has so many details. It's just, like, I can't even describe it. Like, it just really looks like someone packed up and left, and it was, like, left or whatever, and it just feels like there's a story waiting to be happening. So love that build. And they also do some really cute makeovers. Like there's Disney princesses. Who does not like Disney princesses? I know a lot of people have done Vanessa, but like I especially like that one. And then they did a nice rainbow cast challenge. Really liked that. They do a lot of like kind of more modern but very small places, like a studio apartment. I personally really like small builds and small places. And like I said, just like pleasant colors, really pleasant colors, really nice little details, just like those little details that really make a house or space or studio feel real. So definitely give them a check out if you really like, you know, builds that really adhere to those little details that I don't bother to do in my builds because I'm just crazy like that. Okay, so now we're next on to Gabrielle. Okay, I don't know if I pronounced that right because I'm stupid. I also, because I recorded something else today, but it wasn't a video recording. It was like a, It was a recording for one of my fiction pieces that just got published, and I don't usually do that, but they asked for one. I'm like, oh, great. I get to write my own writing. But anyway, I should shut up. Also, I taught today, so my voice is, like, really getting, ugh. So forgive me for that. But anyway, yes, so my favorite thing on their channel is definitely the Disney Princess Challenge, which I only just started watching, which I usually am not in. I always keep saying I'm not into stuff, but, like, honestly, I kind of am not sometimes. But, like, I really like this. So this, I believe we're on Snow White right now. You guys know more about that stuff probably than I do, about, like, how that's those challenges work. So I'm not going to explain it. But I just really like the dynamics, and I think it's really interesting, and it's well done. The other thing that they do is they are a nice, talented builder. They like to do community lots, and also just, like, rustic stuff, like this barn build. I'm kind of a sucker for barn builds, but I love it. But they also did this really cute apartment build. So, like, they do all different kinds of builds. They're not large-scale builds. Again, they're kind of smaller builds, but they're really fun. And I'm trying to think if there's something else I want to talk about. Definitely, they have a lot of creativism stuff. Unfortunately, I have not gotten, I'm not going to lie, like, some of these stuff, like, if it's, like, over a month old, I probably haven't seen it, guys. So I can't, like, specifically say, oh, yeah, I can't, like, I'm not going to lie and say, oh, I'm going to recommend that specifically. It looks good to me. Obviously, I do want to get to it eventually. But like I said, just a lot of, you know, community lots and stuff like that. And I really like seeing people do community lots. And just everybody has just a different signature touch on stuff. So definitely do recommend for community lots and, again, for the Disney Princess Challenge. So now we're moving on to a fairly more well-known simmer, as in, like, more well-known as in, you know, like, not huge, but, like, bigger, way bigger than the other people I was talking about in terms of followers. I don't mean that in a mean way whatsoever. Like, I'm smaller. You know what I mean? So a slightly bigger simmer, however, still deserves more subs, to be honest, and deserves more views. So this is Queen T, also another lovely person. Haven't talked to Queen T personally as much, like the other people I talked, like, specifically to. So interacted a bit with Queen T, don't know them quite as well, a little bit newer to knowing them. And kind of a little bit newer to checking out their channel. If anybody, which I'm gonna not gonna lie, I don't like the Kardashians, but if anyone likes the Kardashians, they did a great creativism right here for Kim Kardashian. Think it was great. I thought it was great, and I don't like Kardashians, so there you go. And then they just are just overall talented. I don't know. There's, like, a variety of content. They do have a Sims 2 Goth Family series, which, guys, I'm a sucker for Sims 2 content, and there's not a ton of people that do it because I can't even run it on my computer, which makes me feel really sad, guys. But yeah, so definitely check that out. And just a bunch of cash challenges. I don't know what this is about, the Stop Racism tag. I don't know. I don't know if they talk about racism. I'm not sure what that is. That looks interesting. Like I said, I'm kind of more new to this channel. But yeah, so definitely some really good cast challenges and The Sims 2 Let's Play. Those are the things I can recommend. And I don't know what else. Oh, yes, I forgot to mention, duh. They recently did these kind of cast series where they're continuing to do, like, real-life celebrities. Like, so there's Ariana Grande, there's Naomi Campbell. And then I do not really know these people. I'm not going to try to pronounce their names, but I actually looked at the people and I was like, holy crap, they look, like, so much alike. You know what I mean? So really, really talented at a cast, and also Sims 2 series. Don't want to miss that. Okay, so next. I promise, guys, we only have 3 more. So if you're hanging on with me so far, just make it through the rest of the video. Okay, so this is, and I will try to go a little bit faster, so no offense to the next people. Like, I love you guys too, I just need to go faster. So this is Sims Astria? I seriously have never known how to pronounce their simming name. I have actually talked to the simmer, but, like, I don't know. Like, you don't ask, how do you pronounce your name? Yeah, so basically what I personally know them for, they actually do have some other gaming content. So if there's anyone who kind of wants to watch a simmer who does other games, which I don't typically, but they have some good stuff. I admit I haven't personally watched the other gaming stuff, but like I said, that could be for someone. They play Mass Effect. I don't know what else they play. Let me check real quick. me being prepared as always. I don't know. I know they play Mass Effect. Maybe that's just a new development. So I'm not sure about that. But anyway, new development, trying to put a little bit different content in, because sometimes, you know, you just need a little refresher. What am I talking about? They just do builds that I just really like. I don't know what to say. Just kind of like more simple, but like really well done. Okay. A lot of very modern stuff. So if you guys like modern stuff, go for that. This minimalist build was lovely. And then actually I haven't watched this, but they have a whole video on roofing techniques. Obviously I haven't watched it. but yeah, so that's really great. And then in addition to the builds, we also have a Rags to Riches Let's Play. I think I've only seen maybe one episode of that, so I can't say a lot about it, because I've pretty much just known them for their builds, honestly, and I've really liked it. However, it does look good, so definitely, if you guys are into Rags to Riches, check that out. So that's their channel. And then my second to last one is The Goddess, another person who has really just supported me from the very beginning. Lovely person, just really kind. My favorite thing on their channel right now is the Bachelor Challenge, which it's kind of funny because they started their Bachelor Challenge, I can't remember, like 2 or 3 episodes after I had posted mine or something like that. Then they started posting theirs. And so I was interested just to see, you know, like how ours were like alike or not. And honestly, theirs is just so much different. They follow the rules a lot better. So if you get annoyed with mine when I don't follow rules and I do stupid stuff, check theirs out because they follow the rules a lot better. Some interesting contestants, definitely some drama, so definitely check that out. They think, oh wow, they already have 7 episodes, so unlike me, who posts episodes very slowly for that challenge, that's one you can just, like, binge watch, like, 7 through, okay? So definitely recommend that. They also do, how do you say that word, mashimas? See, I don't know. I don't do those, obviously. But they also have Mashimas. There's this Rise of the Amazon Queens. I think they've done something else. You know, so if you like something like that, definitely check that out. I don't think any of the other simmers I mentioned have that. So that's really unique. Okay, and then finally, we have Lexi Rue Gaming. I think Lexi... no, I don't know. Because that's not right. I think Lexi's really new, too. I should just stop looking at that. I'm sorry, my dog is barking in the background. So anyway, I'm just going to finish this up really quickly because my dog is going crazy. Lexi Rue does this whole Do Copy Cast series, really great. They also do this SimSelf kind of Let's Play, kind of fun. I've only seen a couple episodes. And they also do lots of great cast challenges, just really talented. And I'm a little bit biased, but they do have a kind of a Road to Stardom kind of Let's Play, and it's kind of funny because one of their main characters is named Aaron, so, you know, that's great. Also, they just do fun stuff like Instagram Picks My Sims, just like really fun videos. Lexi, I don't know if that's their real name, but just has a lot of energy, and just a really, really kind soul as well. And Lexi also collabs with tons of people, like tons of simmers, which I'm not good about that kind of stuff. So, like, if you're looking for someone to collab with, they potentially could... Well, I shouldn't say that because I don't want to advertise for it. But, like, I'm just saying, like, I really admire that they are very active in the community. Of all these people, like, extremely active in the community. So that's really great. And, guys, that does wrap up all of my simmers, small simmers for this one. I do want to feature some more. So if I know you or whatever and you weren't mentioned, please don't have your feelings hurt. I just picked a couple that I wanted to feature right now. And just remember, guys, no matter how small your channel is, your content matters. And I guess that's all I'm going to say, but please check those channels out. And thank you for putting up with this. Like I said, it's not as exciting because I don't have a face cam, but I am going to let you go on that note. Please be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. Ring the bell for notifications for my videos. I don't usually do videos like this, but do that. And just let me know if you have any other suggestions or anything that you would like to suggest for my channel. Okay, bye guys.